was the glamour girl of the 90s who had it all. She was the multi-millionaire model who graced the cover of Vogue. Kate Fischer rose to fame at just 13 after taking out the Dolly cover girl competition before becoming a regular on our screens.
Sea slugs do that. When they get attacked, they spit their insides out.
Once engaged to billionaire James Packer, the former supermodel and actress lived the high life. But it was her self-described fall from grace in 2011 when Kate, who converted to Judaism and changed her name to Zipporah Malkah, found herself homeless and living in a Melbourne women's shelter.
Yeah, we can do it right now. Now, she's using her experiences to help other women rebuild their lives. And Zipporah's with us live in the studio. We just said that you converted, but you were born Jewish, so...
I have a Jewish family,
we're
yes.
Correct, yes. We're correct
yes,
on that.
Yes, yes,
well, you know, I asked you then when all this photo started coming up. I said, how do you feel about when people flash up those photos about your past? And you said this.
I said, why are you doing it? I lived it, and so that's all fine with me. It's all great for you. But I'm here to talk about White Caravan. And so when people put me on a show, go, look how beautiful she once was, young and skinny and rich, and now look at her now, old, fat, and used to be homeless. Okay, oh, that's all we've got time for now. Bye, everybody. That doesn't make me feel good.
But that doesn't... That's
not why I'm here.
That's not why you're here. And also, that's not your value of who you are anymore.
No, I think I've got a lot more... I've got a lot more to talk about. I get it.
Yes, but I think it's because you have so many layers to your life, and that's what's interesting for people. And the fact that you are here to talk about White Caravan, which is what we're going to do right now, because you found yourself in this situation.
And a lot of women do, and it's not just because she was done with her money. A lot of women find themselves in this situation, doesn't matter how.
No.
And a lot of people who have come forward say, my mum's, you know, about to start couch surfing. My mum's, you know, dad just sold the house out of mum's name and sent their money to another foreign country or sent money somewhere. All that kind of stuff. A lot of women can become homeless.
Yes.
And no one expects that. It's the one thing everyone says, I never, ever expected to be here.
And certainly women after a certain age, when they're not expecting it because they've been married, they've had kids, this is the high level of growth in the homeless.
This is pandemic. At the moment, 50 is the new homeless. 50-year-old women in Australia, and it's disgraceful. And we need to do something about it. And there are sort of some places that you can go to, but White Caravan is more, it's not crisis housing per se. It's not as if you were in a crisis, they kick you out.
Mm.
But it's more transitional housing where you go if you just need a few months to kind of just go, what the heck happened, get back on your feet, get a little bit of financial planning behind you, get some educational skills behind you, that kind of stuff, and you renovate your own caravan.
So let's just talk about it as a concept, because people need to know what it is. So these are caravans that have been, that are not being used anymore, that are being renovated as... as shelters for
and
women.
Lots of Aussies have caravans in their back gardens, daffodils are not using them, so you can always donate them to us. But they're portable, and they can sort of go anywhere. They can, and we don't necessarily have to say where they are.
Yeah.
So you can have one in someone's backyard or one somewhere, and then it can be moved.
Not
that infrastructure. Much infrastructure isn't required either. Sorry, David.
No, it's okay. When people talk about homelessness in this country and what it means to be homeless, there's words that come up. Invisibility is one of them.
Mm-hmm.
A lack of the lowest self-worth that you'll ever experience in your life. Sort of being all at sea emotionally and not knowing where you are anymore. The risks of living on the street. Are these the things that really, when you were going down this path that was happening to you and you were going, oh my God, what am I going to do here?
Yeah.
These are the things that were resonating in your life.
Oh, absolutely, and I didn't know. I had no idea there was something about transitional housing. So I just thought I was going to have to sleep rough, you know.
I really did.
I had no idea, and I'd come from this big life in Beverly Hills to this.
Mm.
I was like, oh, my God. So I typed in Melbourne, homeless, and luckily I found a shelter to live in for 2 years where I got my Certificate 3 and started getting a job, and then I could get into private accommodation after 2 years.
Yeah, yeah.
But still living on the poverty line.
When you said private accommodation, I heard you say that to Georgie as well, and people may have missed it, but... it wasn't nice, probably. It's not like you went to a nice place.
No. I had to go to quite a horrible place to build up my rental credit score to get into a nicer place.
Mm.
It was terrible. It was absolutely terrible. And it's this with White Caravan, I mean, we're getting like
people in to come help decorate them. Lots of people are throwing their resources, but not enough people. We always need more.
I was going to say, some of them look really, really nice. And probably about the size of a one-bedroom Sydney apartment.
And you know what? Had that been an option for me, of course, I'm so grateful to Women's Housing in Melbourne for what they did for me.
Yeah.
But had it been like, there's a few caravans we've got out the back. Would any ladies like to live in there? Your own little cooking space, your own little toilet, your own little shower, your own little space, your own little TV, and you don't have people running around in the middle of the night or anything. Yeah. And just having that, your own space.
That you can close the door, lock the door, and feel safe.
Yeah, and feel safe and feel like it's yours because you've done it up yourself.
Yeah. So you went through that, and now you're coming out the other side.
Mm-hmm.
What's your message for women who are, you know, they might find themselves in the depths of despair because they are financially bereft, you know, for whatever circumstance?
Oh,
what would you say?
Oh, no, there's, I don't know. What can you say? I mean, it's just, you've just got to keep going.
Well, the thing that you did, I mean, you went out and you got your certificate to go into nursing, didn't you?
Yeah.
And now you've found love. So to me, it seems like your life has turned around, and that's what most people are looking for, hope.
I think that with me is that if it wasn't for the fact that paparazzi had sat outside of my house for weeks to get a shot of me in a sheet looking vulnerable and revolting, which was not planned and not set up at all, I would actually still be doing aged care, struggling. Maybe not have found that love, still be depressed, still have all those things. It's only because I had a social, as you said, saw those pictures before, I had a media thing going before, and because then that sheet was so terrible, that picture, so cruel, so devastating, and then that happened, and now I've got a social, now I've got a media career again. Look, I'm 44 years old, I'm not pretty young Kate Fisher, I've still got a whole ass, do you know what I mean, to make a buck? But like, it's easier for me now than it was for me being an aged care worker. You know, because I'm now back in the media.
Yes.
But it's not because I've done all that. That's happened because I had a past in that. And it's only because the paparazzi did that. By the way, this same paparazzi went to my manager last week and said, she's starting to look mentally ill in those sheets. I think we need to, you know, you need to talk to her. She's starting to look like she's mentally ill. And then the next day he was parked outside of my house. Can I get a picture of me?
Mm.
It's like, excuse me, but I'm doing the sheet thing and I didn't want to blow it too early, but we're doing the sheet thing intentionally, because it's a sign. People are like, why is she doing this all the time? Is she mental? No, it's now become a symbol, but you're going to have to watch this space.
Okay, so the White Caravan, is there a website for that?
White Caravan, yes, absolutely, there is.
We should have that.
We should have it up there right now, whitecaravan.org.au. Go there. Thanks for spreading this message and coming in, and it's great to see you. Great to see you looking well.
Thank you.
And coming back. It's good to see
you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you so much for having me.
Of course. Anytime.
Oh, good.
Coming up on Today Extra, raising her voice, why Australia...